Are you ready for some good news? If the grace of God is powerful enough to save you, redeem you, and make you a co-heir with Christ, that same grace is powerful enough to transform any relationship, especially your marriage. Here's today's text, Genesis chapter 2, verse 25. And the man and his wife were both naked and were not ashamed. Today's broadcast begins a unique series based on a marriage conference that my wife and I have led. I'm convinced that what our marriages and all relationships need isn't more good advice. We need more good news. Keep in mind, the principles we'll see today and in coming days aren't just for marriage. There's help here for all relationships. Before Adam and Eve sinned, their marriage knew only grace. They knew no shame. In grace, there is no fear of rejection. In grace, there is no insecurity. Where there is no insecurity, there is no self-absorption. Life and relationship can only be enjoyed in grace. Whenever law enters a relationship, if you don't do as I want, then I'll reject you, fear enters. And that's what happened to Adam and Eve. As soon as they sinned, they became creatures of law and condemnation. They began to hide from one another because grace had been swallowed up in shame. The deep, painful awareness of possible rejection created an insidious uncertainty in their souls. That insecurity, the uncertainty of love, creates havoc in the relationship. All human intimacy requires risky self-disclosure. Such vulnerability only flourishes in an atmosphere of grace. Grace says, even though you are imperfect, I will love you. Thus, as grace multiplies, so does the trust and intimacy in marriage. If the husband and wife swim in the deep waters of God's rich mercies, they have grace to offer one another. In God's kind of marriage, grace multiplies. Marriage is God's great design for grace to flourish in the confidence of a covenant. If you want an abundant marriage, let God's grace be your aim in all things. It's grace times two, and that's the gospel. Well, that's today's daily devotional. And if you want to learn more to strengthen your marriage or other relationships, you can get this whole radio broadcast and other messages for free at sharingthelight.org.